Describe Ethereum to the average person, why it's important.
Yeah, so first of all, there's two kinds of average people. There's the average person who has already heard of Bitcoin, and there's the average person who hasn't. Right. So, I mean, for the first category, it's a bit easier because if you understand what Bitcoin is, and you understand that it's a peer-to-peer digital currency, and you understand that if you want to have a digital currency that's decentralized, then the like you need some kind of database to store how much money everyone has, right? Like if I have 100, you know, digital Bitcoin dollars or digital whatever, you know, cash, and I send 100 to you, and I also send the same 100 to someone else, then those are two transactions, either one of which is legal by itself, but both of which are illegal in combination because they'd be turning 100 units of cash into 200. And this is the classic double spending problem, and in order to solve it, you basically need to have some system that keeps track of, you know, have these coins already been spent? How much money do I actually have at any given time? How much money do I have the right to spend at any given time? And you can very easily do this with a centralized server, but if you want to do this in a way that's decentralized, which is, you know, Bitcoin's original point in the spirit of things like BitTorrent, you know, it's actually a very hard computer science problem to figure out how to do it. And Satoshi Nakamoto probably came up with the first solution that, you know, really is practical in this kind of open permissionless context, which is, you know, the Nakamoto blockchain. And that was where, you know, the idea of blockchain technology in general came from. Now, where Ethereum comes from is basically you take that idea, the idea that you can use what I call crypto economics, so a combination of cryptographic algorithms, things like hashing and digital signatures, and the kinds of economic incentives that keep systems like Bitcoin going, and use them to create these kind of decentralized networks with memory, so these kind of decentralized database-like things for a whole bunch of other applications as well. Right, so around 2013, people started realizing really that these blockchains are usable for much more than peer-to-peer digital currency. And the first major thing aside from Bitcoin was probably Namecoin, which was trying to do a peer-to-peer decentralized DNS. But then people started thinking, you know, can you do other kinds of digital assets? Can you do smart contracts? Can you do financial agreements? Can you do registries about identity? Can you do all these other things? And there were so many applications that building a blockchain for each one doesn't really work. And so the core idea behind Ethereum is, you know, you can have a general purpose blockchain. We can have a blockchain where instead of the blockchain working like a Swiss Army knife where you have, you know, five different tools for five different categories of applications, you have a blockchain that understands a general purpose programming language. So, you know, kind of like your phone, you know, in your phone you have Android or, you know, iOS. And inside of Android or inside of iOS, you can have apps. The apps are written in, you know, whatever programming language they're written in. Anyone can create an app. Anyone can download an app and run it. So that was the kind of general purpose flexibility I was trying to bring to the blockchain world.
Yeah, it's amazing. The concept of a Turing complete blockchain in the computer science speak that can execute any arbitrary program given enough resources is pretty incredible. And it seems daunting because the idea of a blockchain is that everybody, implementation of the blockchain is that everybody executes a copy of the code on themselves to verify that what is supposed to happen actually happens. So that begets a whole slew of problems like scaling and trust and so on. But just kind of easing into that, what kinds of applic-